welcome to our brand new and newly commissioned high-speed test lab here at PC1. And this is the very first part of the very first prototype GT50 engine, our very first starter generator unit. And this demonstrates that we've now met the first major milestone in the GT50 engine testing program of getting this prototype hardware onto the test bench by the end of Q4 2024. Over the course of the last few weeks and months, you've watched us painstakingly engineer and manufacture each of the components, measure them to incredibly tight tolerances, and then over the last few weeks, bring both the electrical hardware, the mechanical components, the sophisticated electronic controls all together into this integrated, sophisticated starter generator system for GT50. What we've done over the last few days is initially run the unit on its own, under its own electrical power, under its own electrical controls, and get that running on a bench just to prove the integrity of the electrical system and the controls. And then over the last couple of days, we've come and mounted it on the high-speed test bench, and then we've started the mechanical integrity testing. So ensuring that the structural dynamic design and the rotor dynamic design are working as required to keep stable operation all the way up to 50,000 RPM. So over the course of the last day or so, we've been running the starter generator unit up to about 17,000 RPM, which is about 35% of its maximum speed. And then we need to slightly improve the alignment we've got between the prime mover system up here and our starter generator, and then we'll be able to run that through the full range of operating speeds. Once that's done, Jen, you can get on and develop all of the electrical characterization. So pulling out all of the key sort of numerical constants that control the way the electrical or the electronic components work and tune the control system to suit our design specifically. And then once we've done that, we're on to performance testing. So proving that the whole system works all the way through the operating range as a motor and also as a generator before going and looking at the extreme temperature conditions. And then finally, the long-term endurance testing, where we prove that this device is good for 5,000 hours and 20,000 cycles, just like the rest of the GT50. There's some other good news too. Not quite as technically complicated, but equally as important, HX50 now has comfortable crew seats. So as you're aware, Tim and Dean have been working away on the cabin crew seat to get all of the mechanical components finished that allow the seats to cope with a warped floor in the event of a crash, designing the energy absorbers that go in the back, providing all the adjustment that we need to fit the biggest and smallest customers. And one of the areas that's been quite a niggly problem to get just right is making sure that the seat is comfortable for everybody within the customer population. So over the course of the last couple of weeks, you've watched us machine some new profiles for the carbon body that goes underneath the seat. And then over the last week, we finally finished producing two more prototype seat foams. So this is the foam that lives inside the leather, with a slightly flatter and more conforming backrest profile to give you better support in the center of your back and the right lumbar support in the right location. And then finally, over the last couple of days, they've produced the latest version of the seat tray, which is inclined slightly further upwards at the front and is made out of a much, much softer foam. And I can tell you, without any exaggeration at all, that we do now have a really, really comfortable crew seat for each and every one of you. So I'm really pleased with this. I think the backrest is absolutely spot on. I think we'll probably go a touch firmer with the foam in the seat cushion, but we won't really be able to make that final call until we've wrapped it in leather, because the leather will tend to stiffen the foam's feel anyway. So we're gonna machine another one of these in January out of a slightly stiffer foam, then we'll leather clad them all, and that's it for the seat. We can get on with the structural testing, well, prototyping, and then structural testing and crash testing. So all that to look forward to in January, and we'll definitely be on schedule with all of that activity as well. So our other major milestone for the end of 2024 was to get the final production version of the PFD of the digital cockpit coded into the software that will be the software on the aircraft and then implemented onto target hardware. So let's have a look. We've got a couple of days left to go yet before year end. Let's have a look at where we're up to. Eric, do you want to show us where we've got to with the latest version of the Digi Cockpit? It looks
Absolutely.
Great.
Absolutely. Yeah, so you all have seen the new design, and so we've taken that design and built it out on, you know, in software, and then deployed that on the actual hardware, or a prototype of the actual hardware that will be on the helicopter. So this is our hardware prototype here with all of the, you know, the display that will be in the helicopter, and then the hardware, electronics hardware in the background powering it. And so got everything built out, nearly done. There's a few little quirks, little bits and pieces, details that need to be cleaned up still. Things like the transponder features, the engine gauges, and the autopilot buttons have not yet been added, but that's a fairly quick job. It's going together really, really well. I'm really happy with how it's coming together. It's looking really nicely, looking really good. And from here on, it's just going to be optimizing and then connecting things to the systems that we've got on the bench over there, and starting to work out the interfaces.
Yeah.
A lot of that, we've already got all of the high-level application, like controllers for different boxes written up, but we have to port those over to the target hardware still,
yeah,
and get those connected. So that will be a big push in early January to get that done. And then we're going to kick off another round for the hardware to get that into a fully packaged, integrated display unit for the helicopter.
Yeah, with the final flight hardware.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Display electronics, everything all in one unit.
Yeah, and the hardware seems to be coping very well. I mean, there's no discernible difference in performance there between a high performance PC that you've been running it on and the electronics that we run it on the platform.
Yeah, that's right. There's no discernible difference. There is actually, it's not quite where I want it yet. It's good and maybe good enough, you could say, but not to what my standard is. So some of that will be more optimization methods. So it's going to be getting into more of the nitty-gritty, and like, for example, maybe some textures on the display are too big of a file size than what I need, and so I can kind of reduce things down and just reduce it down to the bare minimum needed, and those types of things speed it up. There's all sorts of optimization techniques we can go, but I mean, it's already passable and I haven't even tried any of those optimization techniques, so I'm not worried about it.
No, it looks great. I'm over the moon with it. Let's get it packaged up, get it on the bench.
Yes.
Hook it all together. Well done. Thank you very much. We're a couple of working days away from the end of 2024, and now we have our own helicopter factory. The two major technical milestones for this year beyond this huge construction project has been to get the Digi Cockpit on the test bench and ready for the comprehensive testing and development program that will go on throughout next year, and to get the starter generator on the test bench and again ready for its detailed development and endurance testing. We've hit both of those. Furthermore, the next milestones in line are the crashworthy seat testing and the electrical system testing. The starter generator is the first part of the electrical system, and we're on track for the rest of the system by the end of Q1 next year. And the crashworthy seat, we've now crossed the final hurdle with that, of getting the comfort surfaces right. We'll make the tools in January and we'll be ready for testing within the first quarter of next year as promised. 2025 promises to be an absolutely fantastic year for the company. We'll get GT50 running for the first time, and then we'll finally get HX50 into the air.